Hello everyone, my name is Paweł Rymsza and today I will show you how to set up lighting for daytime and nighttime. The first things first, it's important to notice that there is no best lighting. It all changes depending on the scene. However, I will try to give you a base guidelines. It's also important to notice we are using Quixel trees. You can find more about those in our different tutorial. So anyway, let's get started. We go into ambience and we can start changing stuff. So the first thing I would like to modify is time of the day. So instead, I like to go for later hours. So let's say something like 6:30. And the reason for that is simple. Our shadows from the trees are longer and we have sun details. We are not using HDRI in this setup, just a simple geolocated sun. So we have sun at 50 and all the other settings are exactly same as in starting setup. Then we have weather. And here I like to change the weather, change it to autumn. And as far as our environment settings, now we're gonna change the sun. So what I would like to achieve here is have some shadows on our elevation. And obviously our elevation need to be lit up. So as you can see right now, we're having some shadows, some brighter parts. And as soon as we switched on Path Tracer, you can see that our image is starting to come together. Okay, so nothing more here. We switched up to camera settings. Here we are having our exposure. You can switch off auto exposure and do it manually. For now, I will keep it as is. And we have something called local exposure. And here, upon enabling, you can modify the highlight reduction and the shadow boost. This will prevent our image from getting overblown. So instead of having super bright sky, we can tune it down a bit. And same with shadows. Instead of having super dark shadows, we can boost it all the way up. So I'm keeping both at one. And then we have a very important setting, which is field of view. This might obviously change depending on the scene. However, here I would like to have a bit more flat field of view. So instead of 90 degrees, which is also 18 millimeters, we cut it by half. So we're having field of view of 45 degrees. Then we can switch on details. And here I like to pump sharpness a bit. Nothing major, around 10, 15 gives best results. As you can see, we have some extra details here and there. Image is slightly sharper. Then we can also switch on parallelism and we can align our camera parallel to our elevation. Now we can just move our camera a bit up and this way we have a very nice setup. Then we have depth of field. We can also enable it. This is very subject to change depending on the scene, obviously, and the peak focus should be always at the center of our building. As you can see, it's around 20 meters. Now we can go into last settings, which is FX. And here we can play with contrast and saturation. I like to go pretty high with contrast, all the way up to 75%. However, we need to tune down the saturation back to around 40. So image is less saturated. So that's all in the settings, and daytime shot is more or less done. We can now go into media and just click on the plus and create a new image. Here we go into image settings and we can change the width and height. So we are going for 1500 width and 2000 height. We can maybe go a bit closer with the camera now. Now we're gonna double that image, so click on the plus and create a night version. So this will be very simple here. I am just gonna go into environment setting and change time of the day. So instead of 6:30, we're gonna go to like 9 p.m. As you can see, we don't have any direct sunlight. And the second step would be go to camera setting and change white balance to 5000. So we are turning the image more into bluish territory. And you can immediately see that it looks much more realistic. Now let's talk about light. Here at evening we have those kind of small lights, and during daytime you can see those are like glass spheres, and that's exactly what's happening here. So a sphere with glass material applied, and inside of it we have omnidirectional light, which is set to very low intensity, around 5 meters range, with shadows on and dusk to dawn setting. So as soon as we go into our ambience and we push time of the day to later stages, you can immediately see that our lights go on. As soon as we go back to the daytime, our lights go off. And the second type of lights which we have are the lights which are inside of our house, and those are actually spotlights. So each spotlight is set to pretty low intensity, around 4 meters range, 111 angle, and we have shadows on, dusk to dawn, same as with our spheres. You can also see how the back of our house look with those kind of lights, and during daytime they are also switched off. In every single shot I'm using exactly same kind of lighting, so there is no difference between the shots. All of them has exactly same settings. If you would like to have different kind of tutorials or see how this scene was built up, let me know in the comments below. Thank you very much and have a great day.